I have put little amount of oil in the sump, so I will spin it to get the oil holes in the crank cleaned well, because this engine spent much time opened like this, and debris could get in those holes easily. When I turned it, I saw small hard pieces. If I repeated the engine without doing this, the debris will be trapped inside the bearings and it will keep grinding inside. So by that I know that at least it's debris free, and now I could install the pistons and rods back. This engine was a dry sump, so now I will be using this scavenge pump for pressure, and I will bypass the pressure pump that was used for this engine. One issue I will have is it will be running without a relief valve, because the standard single pump type had the relief valve housed in the main pump. And the relief valve was in a valve mounted to the oil tank, we'll deal with that later. A look inside, down the sump. The first piston is ready to go in. With this engine there was a set of rings, new, but there was no oil scraper rings new, so I installed the compression rings, new compression rings. And I think about this, someone in the past has fitted these shells onto its big end bearing, all three rods are like that. Let's see how it goes. Went to insert the piston down the bore, but the connecting rod doesn't fit. Silly me, I haven't checked it before. Now, these undercuts. Today, I found out why they are there. They are there so the connecting rods fits in that just as the gungeon pin goes sliding. That's the only way how you can install the pistons with rods. Other than that, you will have to insert the liners after the connecting rods and pistons. Hope this method works well.